Hello, my name is Chris Howard, and I am a serial non-responder to texts. Excuse my appearance, it's finals week, and I'm procrastinating studying C++ to get this off of my chest. As I talk with you now, my phone currently has 5 unread messages that I have read multiple times, and known every single time I have to respond to that. I have to respond to that. The problem is, all of them I have to deliver bad news. In fact, there's one friend in particular that I need to admit that I need to cancel our plans to be together that we had made weeks ago. I just can't bring myself to. I'm a very non-confrontational person, which has serious downsides. I know that by delaying the delivery of these bad news, I am just building up hopes that ultimately I will dash. And it'd be better to just rip the band-aid off and just do it. I know that. But I'm too much of a coward to rip the band-aid off. I was never a rip the band-aid off kind of kid. I was never the one that jumps into the pool in a cannonball. I was always the toe dipper. And that mindset is causing me so many problems now. Another way that this mindset, or not even mindset, truly it's fear. Another way that this fear expresses itself in my life is, for example, when I visit a new restaurant full of wonderful new opportunities, I typically will look to the things that I know on the menu. Because new things are scary and I could potentially not like them, or they could cause problems for me down the road. And there's a big temptation with this to simply assign it to, that's the way that I've always been, and I have to stay true to my former self because this is just who I am. This is my identity. But there is no former self. Your former self is dead. They do not exist. All that exists is you today. I heard this from Hank Green and have really tried to apply it over the past month. And that comes from stepping way out of my comfort zone when it comes to food or just new experiences. I have a confession for you. I full-on, straight, ate a tomato the other day. Nothing on it, just to see if I could. Hating tomatoes has been such an integral part of who I understand myself to be for so long that it almost felt like a betrayal of myself to eat it. But I ate it. And while I can't say that I enjoyed it, I didn't hate it as much as my former self did. The Chris that detested tomatoes is dead. He does not exist anymore. The Chris that is scared to experiment with food or life experiences is dead. And the Chris that is notoriously just bad at texting, that's just the way that I am, is dead. All that matters is the next decision. I'm gonna send those texts right now, on camera. I'm gonna be honest, this is really scary. I want to just retreat or use the excuse of, sorry, finals made things crazy. I just didn't have time to look at my phone. But that's not true. And these friends deserve the truth. And the thing is too, the decisions that I make today will be past Chris and the life direction that he decided to take his life in 5 years, 10 years, when I'm 70. The idea of who you think you are is dead. And all that matters are your actions, your next decision. Grrrr. It's done. I just sent it. You know, I was expecting like a rush of feel-good emotions, and all that's running through me right now is like fear. But it's good. This right here, this tiny little step, was a step forward. And a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single footstep. I am resolving to, by one decision at a time, by one text at a time, become the good texter. The guy who responds to messages quickly. And I know the bar is low, that's so basic, but that is just a side of the better person that I want to become. One decision at a time.